Good morning, guys. If you don't know me, my name is Curtis. I'm an HVAC tech and a small business owner. After multiple questions and partnering with a new group, I'm gonna start a series on the steps to become an HVAC tech, and specifically that's what we're gonna talk about today and other topics to come. Stay tuned. All right, first let me talk to you about hiring an HVAC tech as a business owner. What I was looking for and what I think everybody's looking for is experience. So if you're just getting started, not having the experience is a hurdle that's hard to cross, especially if there's a market that's saturated with HVAC techs, which in my experience right now is not the case. If you can go to tech school and finish tech school and get some hands-on experience, that may help you get your foot in the door. They want you to have some kind of experience. And don't be surprised if you don't get the exact job you're looking for. Every job is a learning experience. I started out doing duct work. I was a duct work helper, crawling under houses and in attics and hooking up ductwork, but you know, that taught me a lot about airflow. And then I was moved to installations, and that taught me a lot about the electrical and what size wires we needed and the installs and some of the metalwork. All of it was a learning experience. So getting your foot in the door with the company and getting some experience is a crucial step. But don't think you can't do it without previously having a job. If you go to the right tech school, and I'm going to mention one here in a second, that may help you get started. I actually did both. I told you I did both. I actually went to tech school while I was working. I had just started working as a technician. The employer I had at the time took me off of installs, put me in a van, and just sent me out there. I couldn't really call myself a technician. I was doing stuff like preventive maintenances, but that always leads into, hey, go look at this one, see if you can fix it. And I didn't know a whole lot. I just didn't. So I enrolled in tech school. And at the time, the tech school here had a good teacher, and I learned a lot. I was able to put what I was learning directly into use the very next day. And I was working full-time and going to school 2, 3, sometimes 4 hours a night for a couple of years. And I understand that is not an option for a lot of people. You may be raising kids at home, or the cost of a tech school is too much. There are other options, and the school I'm partnering with in this video is a good option on that. Now, both as an experienced technician and a business owner, when we're looking for a new technician or somebody to hire, the hands-on experience is crucial. So what I'm about to tell you about this school that I'm partnering with, and it's called Preppy. It's an online course that's affordable. You can study at your own pace. You have to pass certain tests to advance through the course. And in the end, they partner with somebody local to you so you can get some hands-on experience. And it may be a local company where you could later apply for a job. So, hey, it's a really good option. At the time, I did not have an option like this. I probably would have taken it, because working full-time and then going to school for about 3 hours at the end of every day was rough. Now, I don't have kids, but if I had kids, that probably wouldn't have been possible. Now, before I sign off on this one, I do want to mention that I think HVAC, or heating, ventilation, and air conditioning, and for a lot of people, refrigeration, HVACR, is the most challenging and most rewarding field of the trades. You got to be full-time HVAC tech, part plumber, and part electrician. There's a lot you got to know. And when I was working, doing other things like duct work and whatnot, I knew I wanted to be a tech, Being a tech is where the money is. And to me, that's the most desirable position in an HVAC company. First of all, you got to know a lot about every aspect of air conditioning. You need to know about airflow and the ductwork. You need to know about installations and the proper size wires to use and how to do a good installation. And then you've got to be able to technically troubleshoot anything you come across in the field. And you may come across really high-tech stuff, inverter-driven systems, communicating systems, to something that's 30 to 40 years old. You need to know it all, or at least have a good understanding of it and know your resources. So becoming an HVAC tech is something that I'm very proud of, something that, honestly, I'll put it this way. I get paid more than any engineer that I've ever known, and it's because I fix the stuff that they design. They never work on it, but I do. So guys, check out Preppy. Like I said, I'm going to leave a link in the video description. Check it out. It may be what you're looking for. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.